Hey everyone, this is Darkstar, and today I want to talk about something that all professional gamblers have to deal with. And everyone says they don't care what people think, but actually everyone does care what people think, right? So we all like to say we don't care what people think, but it affects you. And one of the problems that anybody that goes into this business is going to have is that your friends and family are going to think most of the time that you're just a degenerate gambler, you know, that you're addicted to gambling, whatever. Even if you can show them that you're winning, they're going to think that you're addicted. And they're going to think that eventually you're going to lose or whatever. So, and, you know, you have to be aware of yourself and honest with yourself too, and make sure that you really are doing this professionally. And so what's the difference really between an addicted gambler and a professional gambler? This question actually came up when I was in college. I had a professor, psychology professor, that was talking about addiction and stuff, and he started talking about gambling addiction. And I remember what he said about this. He said the difference, even though there are people that are addicted to gambling, and there are people that make their living gambling. So how do you know if you are a professional gambler or if you are a gambling addict? And is there really a difference? Well, the difference, as he put it, is that the addict measures his or her success in the exact opposite way that the professional does, okay? So if your idea of a successful gambling trip is that you were able to play for X amount of hours on X bankroll, then you are talking like an addict, and you are probably an addict. You might also just be a recreational player, and you're trying to get as much money, much fun for your money as possible. But a professional looks at exactly the opposite. They're trying to see how much money they can make, so how much profit they made in as little time as possible. So it's the money per hour that you're making, not the hours and hours of fun that you're having on a certain bankroll. Okay? You want to make as much money in as short of time as possible if you're a professional. So that's the big difference there. I think that's how you can just ask yourself that question and answer it honestly, and you'll know right there. Also, in order for it to be an addiction, it has to negatively impact your life, okay? So, if you're married and your spouse leaves you because of your gambling, that's a negative impact on your life. Now, it could be that you're a professional gambler and she just doesn't want to deal with that. It's still a negative impact on your life, but you have to then make the conscious choice. What is more important to you? So everyone's going to have to decide for themselves how they want to handle that. Because if you're single, it's going to be a lot easier than if you're married, for example. And one of the things that you don't want to get involved in, at least I don't think so, is lying to all the people in your life about what it is that you do. Now, it's important that you don't want to tell everybody that you're a professional card counter. You don't need to tell just complete strangers that, because you never know who actually works in the casino or knows someone that works in the casino. And you are going to have some sort of backstory while you're in the casino, some reason, you know, why you're there, what you do for a living, why you've traveled to that particular casino and why you're there at that time. So you're going to have to figure out what your backstory is going to be, but you don't necessarily want to be giving that same backstory to everyone in your life and constantly having to explain where you're going every day. You know, you don't want to tell your spouse that you're going to your accounting job or whatever and you're really getting on a plane and flying to Vegas. You know, that's not going to work. That's going to cause problems. Okay? So so everyone needs to figure that out on their own, how they want to handle that. I just want to bring it up that it's something to think about. For those of you that are just starting off in this profession, it's something that is going to come up. you are going to have people that are going to think that you are an addict or whatever, and that's something that you're going to have to take into consideration. All right, everyone. That's all I've got for you for today. Please make sure you subscribe and set your notifications on so that you can find out about new shows when they come out. Please send your comments. You can put your comments down below, or you can always email me at darkstarblackjack21@gmail.com. All right. Any ideas for shows, things like that, I love it. Anything you didn't like about the video, be awesome to get emails. You know, I'm just talking here and I don't show my face, so sometimes I don't know what to do with the video part. If you guys got ideas for that, let me know. Please like the video and please subscribe. May the count be with you.